Hello everyone. I'm very happy that Delphine and Carole Insoumise is presented as part of the Film More Festival in Turkey. So I'm Calista McNulty, the director and co-author of the film. And I was asked to describe the film in a few sentences. So the film is about two women that I find very inspiring. The French actress Delphine Seyrig, and her encounter with Carole Roussopoulos, who was a video pioneer in the 70s, and who also happened to be my grandmother, and a wonderful one. So for this film, I wanted to show their relationship that was both one of friendship between two women, but also a very political and creative one. How they used video as a tool for political emancipation and to give voice to other women from different backgrounds and different countries as well. You'll see the film is only made using archives, so existing footage, and really the whole challenge in a way in the making of the film was to bind together all these voices of women, all these clips, all these interviews and video clips from their works. So the story behind the film is that Carole Roussopoulos had begun a project on Delphine Seyrig a couple of years before she died in 2009. And she wasn't really able to complete it. And so for a couple of years, we had this desire to do something with this unfinished maquette, this prototype film that she had done with Carole's children, so Alexandra and Geronimo Roussopoulos. And we started talking with Le Centre Audiovisuel Simone de Beauvoir, who are the co-producers, and also Sophie de Heges, the producer of the film. And we realized quite soon that it didn't really make sense to finish, to complete Carole Roussopoulos' project on Delphine Seyrig, but that we really wanted to include Carole's voice in the story to tell the story of both of these women, because there was something very striking about their collaborative works, their videos that they made together, where there's a lot of anger, but there's also a lot of humor and creative energy, and I think it's quite specific of their encounter, on this very fertile encounter. And so the maquette of Carole really shifted from a film on Delphine Seyrig as an actress and as someone politically engaged, into Delphine and Carole and this encounter and this this idea of solidarity between two women, and also being in solidarity with other women in France, but also in other countries. There was another question. So what was the reaction to the film in my country, so in France? The reaction has been very positive. I think it's a story that's, of course, that is based in France. And although Carole Roussopoulos was Swiss, she lived in France for most of her life. But I think it resonates. It resonates a lot even today with what's happening, because even though it's the 70s, I think they're dealing with issues that are still relevant, whether it's stereotypes that are associated to women and that can limit our freedom, or issues of sexuality, of abortion. Abortion is not an issue in France, but it is in many countries, and it's and we've seen in countries like the United States that even these rights that seem to be very much achieved and rooted in the idea of freedom can just like go away very easily. So I think feminism in a way is a tool of vigilance to make sure that we don't go back, and that we keep questioning our condition and other people's conditions, and that we understand inequality. So I think that that even those issues that we're dealing with in the film present resonances today, and also that they have a way of being politically engaged and committed that I think is very inspiring for me anyway, and I think for a lot of the public. They say that these women give them energy, and that I think there's a type of creative energy and anger and humor that's quite contagious, and that's something that I felt as a director, and I tried to convey in the film. And I think from the conversations I've had with spectators, women but also men, that they can really relate to how these women lived their lives and decided to be involved politically. And actually, I think also that the film has traveled a lot in various festivals around the world, so in Europe, but also in Asia, in Taiwan, in South Korea, in the US, in Algeria, and this story seems to speak to all the audiences from all these countries. So I think there's something quite universal in a way about Delphine and Carole, about their work, about their friendship. We're dealing with things that I think can, that even though the context of reception is different from country to country, it can in a way shed light to what's happening in these different countries, and it resonates. So I hope you'll enjoy the film, and again, thank you for showing Delphine and Carole, and I hope you'll that will give you energy, and enjoy the film.